First Minister Mark Drakeford boasted about how his more invasive lockdown restrictions have put Wales in a better position than England.
Wales is taking action, as is Scotland, as is Northern Ireland, and as are countries right across Europe and right across the globe. The one country that stands out as not taking action to protect its population is England.
Really? Here's a graph of case numbers since Wales imposed the additional restrictions compared to England. You'll notice that if, apparently unlike Mark Drakeford, you have the ability to read and see, case numbers in Wales have risen 3 times faster than England. But go on, Mark, tell us more about how wetting the bed has put Wales in a better position than England. And I'll keep showing you the graph that makes you look like an absolute tosser.
So the question is not why is Wales not following what is going on in England. The real question is why is England such a global outlier?
Why is England not following Wales? Because despite your indoor mask mandates, your nonsense rule of six, and your closing of nightclubs, you have significantly higher case numbers than England, you prat! Your case numbers have almost doubled since December 26, a 94% increase compared to England's 34%. There are more than 2,300 cases per 100,000 people across Wales compared to 1,271 across England. So what are you even banging on about? You've got to ask the question at this point, is Mark Drakeford so offensively stupid that he struggles to comprehend basic information? Or is he just a lying sack of shit? Recent history would suggest the latter to be true. As a justification for imposing the restrictions in the first place, Drakeford brazenly lied in claiming Omicron was probably as severe as Delta, despite numerous other studies out of South Africa and other countries proving the opposite to be the case. This prompted Jamie Jenkins, former head of health analysis at the Office for National Statistics, to assert that the Welsh First Minister had made a, quote, untrue statement with the intent to deceive. In other words, he was lying out of his arse. And don't forget what happened with the Welsh vaccine passport scheme, which only passed the Welsh Parliament because a single Tory MP was unable to log in to vote against it via a Zoom call.
And clearly we still have a member who's desperately trying to get into Zoom, but cannot get it.
No, Darren Millar. We are holding the vote. No.
This was clearly a shambolic farce, made a mockery of the very notion of democracy, and shouldn't have been allowed to stand. Now, because of that fraud, and because of Mark Drakeford's belief that relentless bedwetting is a good way of running a country, livelihoods will continue to be ruined, businesses will continue to go bust, jobs will continue to disappear, and families will continue to be kept apart, potentially for months longer. And purely because this creature keeps lying to the public and evading the consequences. To get exclusive content, early access, behind the scenes stuff, and to personally interact with me, please sign up for my community at pauljosephwatson.locals.com. Link in description, and thank you for your generous support.